Hey, this is YBR with BM&G Drive, and today we are going to go to one of the world's most well-known racetracks. We are going to the Nürburgring. Can't you tell by this picture right here? Yeah, the picture, it's not updated, actually. The picture is just a picture of grid map, but the map itself totally works. It's, oh, jeez. And when you start, I forgot about that. When you start, your doors blow open like that. Just boom. Your truck's blown up already. So normally when I do a video like this, I would do a whole lap in a stock car and then use a modded car. With the fact that this place is so big, I'm only going to do some of it with a stock car, and when I get bored of that, then we will use a different car. So let's use a Red Bolide, because this is called the Green Hell. At least that's a nickname for it, I should say, and the hell is red. Yes, that totally makes sense. I don't know where I was going with that for sure, but I saved it totally. So the map you're seeing right now is ported from, I believe it was Race 07 or GTR Evolution. I really don't know which. Maybe it was the same map in both games. That is what I think it might be. I do know they were both made by the same company. They were both made by Simbin, so that's probably the case, but I'm not 100% on that. So anyways, one way to tell if this map is a good variant of the map is if I flip over, because anytime I play this map in any game, what always happens is I'll try to do a corner like this where I cut it in too deep and I'll flip over and crash and die. So if that happens ever, that means it's a good variant of the map. If it doesn't, it's a bad variant. And right there we crashed just because I was trying to show you a huge emphasis on what I usually accidentally do, and we ended up crashing. But no problem with that. This is BM&G Drive. Crashes happen, crashes should happen. But you know, it's just the way I drive. I always try to cut corners just a little too tight. I always think, oh, this car's not going to steer enough, and I could go cut right through the corner. Now, I want to show you this, though. The grass, it doesn't slow you down at all. You can just drive through the grass without a care in the world, and it doesn't seem to slow you down. The walls are sometimes grabby, like right there it was grabby, but then sometimes they're not grabby. It just depends on the wall. So like that one, it grabbed me, but we could drive 100 feet up the road, and sometimes we'll just bounce off it, like that one, see? So it's pretty much random if the wall will hit you or not and suck you in like a black hole, like some of them do. And that's just a problem that happens with a lot of maps that are ported over. I don't know the technical reason exactly why, but I'm assuming it has something to do with the mesh not working quite right. I don't know. I just know it happens when you port maps over. But we keep on racing. Now the map, you know, you're seeing it right now. It doesn't look the greatest. You could tell this is supposed to be the ring when you're driving around it, right? But it's not that pretty. When they made it for that game, it was a long time ago. Graphics weren't this great back then, so it's honestly a little ugly. I will say that. But that's not really the guy who ported the map fault, nor is it the map creator's fault. It's just it's an old model of the map. So it's just gonna be low polygon count. It's just the way things are. Low detail, whatever. That's okay. We could keep driving on it. And you see, I am not really driving exceptionally or anything. I'm just going through a relaxed state, not really caring about anything. And if I go through a dirt, I go through the dirt because, well, it doesn't matter if I go through the dirt. We don't slow down at all. You see, just don't care. Don't care because the dirt doesn't slow you down. So now that we've done some driving with this car, let's go ahead and use another car. So we're just going to, yep, slam into a wall accidentally. That was because I took my hand off the controller. I just set the controller down, and then the car's like, I'm going to go hit this wall, okay? And it's like, okay, and smack. So let's try using the Lancer Evolution. Now with this car, I have an excuse. Whoops, that was not the button I meant to hit. But with this car, I have an excuse when I hit go off the course and go off-roading because, well, hey, this is a rally car. It could do whatever it wants. If it wants to cut through the corner like this, it can. It's a rally car. You don't tell a rally car to stay on the road. You just don't do that. Now, you didn't notice there's a little bit of graphical oddities sometimes in the distance. If you look out here, you kind of see some funkiness. Now you can't because there's trees. Hold on. Let me just do a quick demonstration. All right. Watch out there. You see how it's all weird? I just wanted to point that out. Just a small thing. Ooh. Look at that, though. There are those vans. Can we drive into them? Can we crash into those? Whoop. Oh. Can we not go up here? I guess there's an invisible wall right here. Maybe. I forget what button it is to show the mesh for the track. Oh, darn it. Oh, well. Let's try this. Let's try just going whoop right here. Aha. What? My car won't move. okay, we can't drive up here because apparently my car does not want to move anymore. It's just like, I'm done being car. I quit. Can we at least go on the van? Yeah. Oh, yeah. Oh, that's good. That's good. Look at that. That should be a thumbnail right there just because it makes no sense. Like, this is for the Nürburgring, and here's a Lancer Evolution sitting on top of two ambulances. Why? Because it happened in the video. Hey, it happened in the video. All right, let's see. The car still drives. It was the ground over there. The ground over there is not meant to be driven on. So the theme of that is stay on the road or the dirt right next to the road. Don't go on the dirt that's next to the dirt because bad things will happen if you try that. Oh goodness, I forgot this thing does have a habit of understeering for me. And I almost crashed into a wall because of that. Well, hey, this is BeamerG Drive. Let's crash into a wall right now anyways. Get some slow-mo too, and yeah. Now, there's really no iconic section for the Nürburgring, really. There's, like, multiples. You know what I mean? When you think Nürburgring, there's just so many different corners and stuff. There's no one corner that's like, this is the iconic one. Like, for example, Laguna Seca, that's just a local racecraft course, so I know it well. That one, it is iconic in the corkscrew. It's just like, that is its turn. Oh my goodness. That thing just tore my tire off. But it's just, it doesn't, there's not that for this map. It's just, I don't know. I'm just thinking randomly about that. Anyway, let's go and reset the car and... Yeah, I'm right now I'm thinking, it's like, you know, there's the flying place, and then you got the, you got some of the carousels, and, I don't know the names for sure, I think something, there's one, like, they have German names, and they have, like, easy-to-pronounce American-style names, like, I know the flying place is called something else totally, it's called, like, I don't know, it's like Flug something, I don't know, but just too many places to just say this is the iconic area. It's just interesting to think about that. It's just because it's so big and so many turns. Anyways, we'll just keep on driving then. Car is not going straight, but that's okay. And we have not flipped over yet, so I'm giving this map a low grade because of that. And my tire just said, I'm going home. The tire's going home. Do you see it? Look at that tire. It's, I'm going home. I'm done here. I'm going home. I'm out of here. Wait. Oh, camera's all crazy. See? So I'm going home. How much is gas? Oh, that's probably per liter, but that's still not that bad. Ooh, Mazda dealership. Ooh, what's in there? Ooh, look at those cars. Does that look like a Mazda car to you? I can't tell. I can't tell. We're all looking at this stupid little detail. Like, ooh, what's that? Ooh, what's this? Like, ooh, what's this? Ooh, it's a restaurant or something. I don't know. I don't know what it says. It's too blurry. I can't read this. I can read the name, but I can't read this. Wait, what does he say here? Oh, it is a restaurant. Yeah, it's a pizzeria. Let's get a pizza. Oh, there's no pizza in here. Nonsense. Oh, wait, this is a racetrack. What are we doing? I'm just like, ooh, stuff. Details. Can you drive on the houses? I'm asking the important questions here, as you see. Oh, we could drive on the houses. Oh, that's good news. Or can we just sit on them? Is it like the ground over there where we can't? Ooh, we can even drive on them. I don't know why we would, but we can. Look at that house. That's the White House. Not the White House where the president is, just it's a White House. Hey, look at this house. What is this house? This is nonsense. This is not even a house. All right, let's go back to the race course. We're screwing around too much. We should just keep on racing. We're only going to complete one lap at this pace, that's for sure. Let's get another car. You know what? I'm bored of this car. We need another car. We need a car that would be more top-heavy and likely to tip over, because it doesn't feel right if I'm not tipping over all the time. So maybe the Renault 5 Turbo, that one might be a little more likely to tip over. I'm not sure. We'll try it out. I'm thinking it's just, it's a, might be a little more top heavy. The rear end is at least, it's more rear end heavy. That's for sure. Oh man, this handle's so different from the car I was just driving. The other one's like, I'm going to understeer all over the place. This one's like, I'm going to oversteer all over the place. Those are exact opposite things. And now I gotta just think differently when I drive. Instead of trying to force it to oversteer all over the place, I gotta make sure I don't oversteer too much and spin out. Say, okay, yeah, that's easy. No. It's actually very difficult. But I'll do the best I can. Ooh, Simbin! That is the people who made it. I was right. I said Simbin, I think it's Simbin. Ooh. See, don't touch the dirt next to the dirt. That's bad news. I couldn't really control my car's direction before that, but that really ruined it. So we just crashed the car. That's not flipping it. That's not what's supposed to happen. I do crash the car all the time, though, so I guess it's realistic there. But, oh, what the? I don't think I hit that. Like, I did hit it, but it felt like I hit something invisible first before I actually hit it. That was unusual. Hold on. That was just, it didn't seem right. I guess I did hit it. Huh? Oh, no, see, I hit that plant, maybe. I don't know. That's probably what happened, is I hit that plant. I didn't know you'd hit the plants. I figured you could drive right through them. They just look like a little detail. Nope, apparently the plants will damage your car. And our car is damaged to the point where it will go right all on its own. Whether I want to or not, we are going to go right, which is very unfortunate. So I just got to keep tapping left and hope you stay straight. And actually, we're okay so far. This car is really short gearing. We're like almost topping out, it feels like, and we're only going like 90 miles per hour. It's not very high gearing. And this thing is very unstable to drive right now because it just keeps wanting to go right. It just wants to go right. Well, hey, look, it's perfect right here. Perfect. I'm not turning at all. It's just doing it all on its own. No. I have to recover it. And I shouldn't have been being lazy and cocky and like, look, no hands. You should have some hands on the steering wheel. Otherwise, that will happen to you. You'll slightly hit a wall ever so lightly, and it'll bust open your hatch, and you'll be sad because you had a Renault 5 Turbo, which aren't that common, and they're really cool, and you just broke your really cool car. That would be sad. Look at that bumper just hanging around. I want to tear it off right here. I'm going to tear it off. Here we go. Oh, it worked. Oh, it worked. I can't believe that actually worked without my car just getting absolutely ruined. Oh, that is amazing. So some of the walls are grabby, some aren't. That one was grabby in all the right places. Just enough for the bumper. And now the car drives even less straight. But hey, I don't have a bumper. It looks cool without a bumper, honestly. It looks more race car-ish because it's like, who needs a bumper? We're going for lightweight. Gotta go fast. Ooh, look at this. This is one of my favorite turns. Yay. Oh god, this car can't turn leftwards though. It's all busted up. Why couldn't we have done the mirrored image of the course, or the reversed, I mean? If we went reversed, it would have been real easy to do that corner. Because I'm going this way, it makes it a struggle. This thing is just all over the place. I can't keep it in a straight line anymore. But it still drives, so I might get rid of it. It still drives. It doesn't drive very fast, though, does it? We're just like going 70. We're barely up to highway speeds with this thing going full throttle. And we've been going full throttle for a while, so let's go ahead and get something else. Let's get something fast. Like, real fast. Like, too fast for my own good. I'm gonna hurt myself fast. Let's use the Impreza. And it's not normally that... Oh, no, white Impreza? No. Not right now. We need a purplish blue. Okay, whatever. It's not normally that fast, but you hit the turbo button, which is T. And, well, it becomes fast. Isn't that convenient? Oh, my goodness, I hit a bush. Don't you hate that when you hit a bush and your whole door just flies off? That is one hell of a tumbleweed. Just tearing off your door. Crazy tumbleweeds. And they're not tumbleweeds, I know. Because they're still rooted into the ground and stuff, but... Meh. Whatever, that was crazy. Look at this. 100 miles per hour, can't make the turn and crash. Told you it was fast. Too fast for my own good. Good news is, even without tires, we can still drive. Well... I mean, it depends on your definition of drive. Your definition of drive is bounce off the walls? Yeah, we can still drive. If your definition of drive is actually have control of the direction you're going in, we can't drive anymore. Nope. Let's go ahead and get back onto the course and keep driving. And again, Subaru Impreza, that is an iconic car that is known for its four-wheel drive system. Well, maybe not known for its four-wheel drive system, but it is a well-known car in the rally kind of stuff. So if we go on the grass, that's A-okay with me. Because it has rally pedigree. So it works great here. Yeah, because it doesn't matter. It really just doesn't matter. The grass doesn't make a difference. I'm going to drive through it if I want to. It doesn't change a thing. In fact, I'm intentionally trying to just drive on the grass the whole time. Because that's something I've never really done before. Because in other games, they punish you for that. It's like, no, you go on the road or we're going to slow you down to just terribly slow speeds. Oh my goodness. I hit a bush. And that really looked like an explosion of car bits going everywhere just from hitting that bush at what seemed like 40 miles per hour. I didn't even think we were going that fast. I thought we were going like maybe 50, 40 miles per hour, and then the car just explodes with parts flying everywhere. So apparently we're going fast after all. I don't like the fact that the bushes blow you up. I will say that now. The bushes blowing you up really sucks. That is the one knock I have for this. That is something the creator could have changed or done something with, I'm pretty sure. Well, it might have been, you might have to do each bush individually, in which case I understand. That'd be a pain. And you see, I think the camera angle is too high. Like if you were playing, well here, look. Let me show you what I was looking at, just in case you didn't see what I was looking at. Hey, car, stop that. If you look over the edges, you see things don't look quite right, do they? Like, I can't explain what's happening over here. Well, okay, it stopped now. But you see, there was some weird stuff right there. I don't know what's going on there. I don't know. Okay, it's not because the camera angle's too high. I was wondering if it's the camera angle's too high. Like, normally, maybe, like, Race or GTR Evolution would use a camera angle like this so you wouldn't see that. But no, we can still see that. I don't really know what that was about. Let's use the interior view. Let's drive. Let's try to drive seriously for a bit and actually get through some of the track, because at the pace I'm going, we're never going to finish a lap, and that is terrible. So I should actually drive a bit, and oops. I lied. I forgot. I can't drive. I'm terrible at this. Who am I kidding? I think we were going this way. Oh, look. 24 hours of Renin. What's Renin? I know I've heard that before. I'm pretty sure, but I don't know why. Oh, well. My poor memory. My other favorite churn. Yay. Oh, God. That was terrible. See, my car just jerked. That's the turbo kicking in. Turbo lag is extreme. And then it goes away in a split second. The turbo's just gone, never clicking it again. That was just me hitting turbo for real. So I was like, I'm gonna hit turbo right here. I didn't die, that's the happy part. Wait a minute, we're on the straightaway. You know what time it is? It's turbo time. I like the whole seat, you just fall back in your seat. Oh goodness, we're flying. We went so fast we started to fly. Yeah, I bet you never seen that happen before in any other video game. You just go so fast on the straightaway, your car flies away, and you end up stuck in a doorway on the Nürburgring. Probably never happened before. Ever. Ever, ever, ever. And look at that, there's a truck over here just sitting here like, ha 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 ha, you guys don't see me, I'm hiding over here. Oh, he took one of my fenders. Who you think you is? Or it took a door. I can't tell what part of the car that is anymore. But it took something of mine. More ambulance things. We did miss a couple of corners over here because we ended up flying across this whole way. But that's okay. And one thing I do like, though, is on this map, when you zoom out like this, they actually detailed it up where there's not just like a blank area. Like some of them, it's just like a blank area in the middle. This one at least has details in the middle area, so no matter what camera angle you take at something, from a distance it won't look so bad. And I want to go over here. I just want to see what it looks like, the little castle. I don't know anything about the castle at all. In fact, I've never noticed that there is a castle right in the middle of the Nürburgring until just now. And I want to see if I could drive on it. Because I have to see, can you drive on it? Well, you could if you wanted to. We need a new car for that, though. Yes. Just do a quick lap of the castle. This is where the real races happen at. The other one, that one's just for the spectators. The real race is a death race right here. We have five cars all on here trying to push each other off and complete five laps and winner take all kind of match. And uh-oh, I'm dead because I can't move anymore. Well, actually, turbo! 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 Turbo won't even get us anywhere. Wait, we're fine. Turbo away! And until next time, this has been YBR on the Nürburgring, or Green Hell, and I know I pronounced that kind of weird, but I don't care. Somebody else say it, so I'm saying that now. I don't care. So, I'll see ya. I thought it would crash eventually. Apparently, it's just going to fall for... Oh, never mind. It's not going to fall forever. That was shocking. That was, that is the sound of YBR being frightened by, you know, other people in horror games. They scream like a wimp. That me, I go, oh, because it was a surprise. So there you go. I was just going to say I don't think it's going to ever crash, but it did eventually. All right. Like I said, see ya.